joining us from New York there. It is now time for a quick chat on workplace law. We do it every fortnight right here on First Business. And the topic of bullying is really front and centre at the moment since the government announced it was proposing amendments to the Fair Work Act. These aim to provide the Fair Work Commission with the jurisdiction to deal with complaints of workplace bullying. Last Thursday, the amendments bill containing these changes passed its first hurdle in Parliament. Here to tell us more is our regular guest commentator Joydeep Paul, managing principal of workplace law firm, People and Culture Strategies. Joydeep, thanks so much for your time. We do appreciate it. First of all, this new legislation, it's passed its first hurdle, as you said there. What does it still need to get through?
Still needs to go through the upper house, but no one's foreshadowing too many difficulties there. We're looking at an implementation timeframe of the next 3 to 6 months. So this is extremely significant legislation. I'd go so far as to say this is probably the most significant piece of workplace relations legislation since the introduction of discrimination laws in the 70s. Because under this, under these laws, if someone feels that a co-worker or their employer has repeatedly acted in an unreasonable manner towards them and it creates a risk to their health and safety, mm-hmm. they can go to the Fair Work Commission, and the Fair Work Commission is going to have the power to make pretty much any orders it sees fit if it finds that there has been bullying, because that is the definition of bullying, other than making any pecuniary penalty. But the scope of that's very significant, because it allows the Fair Work Commission to, for example, impose on an employer an order that is something along the lines of, you've got to put in place measures so that these two people don't work together. Or you have to subject one of your high-performing employees, because we think they've been a bully, to a counselling program or a performance improvement program. Very subjective, and if you go back to that definition of behaving in a manner that's not reasonable, well, what's reasonable to one person is certainly...
Yeah, incredibly subjective. How do things sit at the moment? So let's compare it to the existing legislation and the rules surrounding bullying.
Yeah, absolutely. At the moment, bullying is only regulated as a health and safety matter. It requires an external authority, like a work cover authority, to go in, investigate and prosecute either the employer or individuals on the basis that they've engaged in unsafe behaviour. There is no remedy at present to allow one individual person to bring a claim against another individual, or their employer for that matter, on the back of that very broad interpretation and that highly subjective definition of what bullying is.
Does it move beyond employees to contractors and volunteers as well?
Absolutely. So the legislation picks up this definition of worker, which will include pretty much anyone who's performing services, whether on a paid or unpaid basis. It'll cover all of your contractors, all of your casuals, volunteers, work experience students, arguably. So it's very, very broad.
Could it perhaps backfire and result in unfair dismissal-type claims?
Yeah, I think some of the statistics that have been put out in the last week suggest that the Fair Work Commission's expecting something like 3,500 claims in the first 12 months in relation to this. And that would not surprise me. I think that is conservative. Once this gets momentum and word gets out that this is a pretty easy way to, for example, if you're an employee who's been performance managed, to maybe bring that process to a halt or otherwise muddy the waters a little bit, we're going to see a lot of it happening. And yes, there are going to be employees who will almost proactively be bringing unfair dismissal claims before the dismissal, because they will see this as a way of making themselves, I hate to say it, but a bit of a protected species, because they'll be in the commission, they'll be able to make noise about being bullied, and a lot of employers are going to say, we don't want to be accused of bullying, so why don't we just let that person sit?
Okay, Joydeep, it's an interesting one, and one we'll continue to watch as it makes its way through the remainder there. All right, thank you very much for joining us.
Pleasure.
Appreciate it. We do need to take